the American Civil War, from 1861 to 1865, the war that caused the most casualties to Americans in any other war. That's right, more casualties than in Vietnam, or the Korean War, or even World War II. A war that, today, honestly, doesn't get talked about enough, in my opinion, in history classes, though is brought up quite a bit in the news today due to the politics surrounding the war. But what doesn't get talked about enough, in my opinion, is the music that went on during the American Civil War. The music you would hear on the battlefield. The music that would amp you up and get you ready to die for Dixie or support your troops in the Union, brother. So the question I have is, why does this music actually kind of slap? First song I'm going to be looking at today is Dixie, a song made for the Confederacy here. The song was purposely made to make you riled up. Think of it as kind of propaganda, you know. You listen to the song, you get amped up, you feel like you're going to die for the land of cotton. Old times there are not forgotten, brother. Let's just take a look at it and see why I think it's a pretty catchy tune. Even if I don't believe in what the Confederacy stands for, I do believe in their good music. Wasn't that just amazing? I think that is the best Civil War song of all time. Doesn't matter if you are with the South or the North. I don't care what you believe. I really don't. If you try to tell me that's not the best song of the Civil War, then you're on something. I mean, I don't know. You must be some Union soy boy or whatever. But for real, guys, I mean, forget about the politics, forget about the casualties, just listen to that song, the banjo on point. And so the Union were like, oh shoot, well we gotta act fast, we gotta hit him back with something. And so Lincoln says to Grant, he's like, Grant, what do we do? And Lincoln got his answer. Grant says, Union Dixie.
Away down south in the land of traitors, rattlesnakes and alligators, right away,
right away,
come away,
come away,
right away,
right away, come away.
Where cotton's king and men are chattels, Union boys will win the battles, right away,
right away,
come away,
come away,
right away,
right away, come away.
We'll all go down to Dixie, away, away. Each Dixie boy must understand that he must mind his Uncle Sam. Away,
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 away.
We'll all go down to Dixie, away,
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 away.
We'll all go down to Dixie.
I'm just speechless. I mean, I don't know what to say. What is there to say? The Union just used the South's greatest song, their most prized possession, and turned it into a diss track. I mean, what more can you say? Studio Union was not messing around. I mean, they heard that banger. They didn't even pay royalty. They didn't get the copyright to even use that tune. They were just like, we'll just steal the beat and we'll see what happens. And it turned out to be a pretty good song. Not at the same level of Dixie, but it was an awesome song in my opinion. Pretty good diss track. And by the way, fun fact, first diss track in the history of the world. So yeah, my man Lincoln, your man Lincoln, he's a trendsetter, okay? But the thing is, Studio Union, they weren't done yet. No. Studio Union was still willing to make more bangers. They were just going to start cranking out the tunes, and we're going to make some great songs, they said. They said that. It's a true fact, too. Read it in a history book. But yeah, Studio Union was ready to combat the Confederacy, not only on the battlefield, but in music, okay? They're great music producers. And the next song we're going to be looking at is another Union song, When Johnny Comes Marching Home.
When Johnny comes marching home again, hurrah, hurrah, we'll give him a hearty welcome then, hurrah, hurrah. Oh, the men will cheer, the boys will shout, the ladies, they will all turn out and we'll all feel gay when Johnny comes marching home, and we'll all feel gay when
marching home.
Y'all thought I was joking. I know you guys thought that I was joking. You guys could not believe it. When you heard me say that the Union was going to drop another banger back at Union Studios, you were like, this guy's not making any sense. But that's the thing. Both sides at this time were just dropping banger after banger. Both sides just decided to go on their own studios and make song after song. Union Studios, great. Confederate Studios, amazing. But the thing that I've noticed so far is that we have yet to actually discuss a song that was based off any historical events during this point in history. And we finally got ourselves that. See, in 1865, just right before the war ended, the Union decided, well, you know what, that Sherman's march thing was pretty impressive, other than the fact that we entirely destroyed Georgia and, you know, Richmond and a lot of other things in the South. But the Union were like, screw it, we already destroyed the South's morale and their infrastructure. Let's just rub it in their face some more with a good old classic song. So for all those people out there who are very sensitive about this subject, I'd love to tell you, please stay. It's a good song. We're not going to listen to it that long. Don't get too offended. And without further ado, we're going to be taking a look at Marching Through Georgia.
Bring the good old bugle, boys. We'll sing another song. Sing it with the spirit that will start the world along. Sing it as we used to sing it 50,000 strong while we were marching through Georgia.
I feel like after listening to all these songs, you know, Dixie, Union Dixie, Johnny Comes Marching Home, and Marching Through Georgia, I feel like these songs kind of tell you what their purpose is. You know, I already mentioned it previously with Dixie that it was propaganda, but in reality, all these songs were propaganda. The greatest point that I'm making here is in Sherman's march to the sea, it was a horrendous event for the South. Not only was the infrastructure ruined in the military, but also the people's lives living in Georgia were completely ruined. When the Union soldier and military pretty much just came over to ransack everything, pillage and rape people. It was a horrible time and it really can be considered a war crime. And yet in Marching Through Georgia, the song paints it almost as a glorious event, something that was necessary and freeing of the South people, which it really didn't do. And Dixie also tells the story of how people are willing to die for the land, which is true, and then also try to paint it as a story that you'll be free and have your own will to do whatever you want, which is true if you are white, but if you are African-American, you're not that free at all. And Johnny Comes Marching Home told the story of a man returning back from battle, triumphant and confident, and everybody welcoming home. Which, yeah, that's true. Soldiers would most likely have been welcomed back home in a triumphant way after the war, but at the same time, a man wouldn't probably feel that good about coming back home. Not for the sense that he wanted to stay in war, but from what all he had seen, and seeing his own brothers die in battle and in war, it was horrendous for the soldiers during the Civil War. These songs are supposed to make you feel patriotic for your country, no matter Confederate or the Union. But in the end, they kind of were just big lies, but honestly, that's what propaganda is. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this journey back in time, looking at songs of the Civil War, and seeing that their ultimate goal, no matter catchy or not, was just to get you riled up, make you feel patriotic, and make you know that what you're fighting for is right. Anyways, guys, I'm JDAR4673. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. And until the next one, bye-bye.